स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर लेसन अबाउट लेबर फोर्स. व्हाट इज द लेबर फोर्स ऑफ अ कंट्री? बेसिकली दीज आर द नंबर ऑफ पीपल विद इन द एज ग्रुप विच वी से द वर्किंग एज. नाउ दिस वर्किंग एज इज डिफरेंट फॉर डिफरेंट कंट्रीज. Like in some of the countries, it starts from after the school leaving age of 16 years till 65 years. But in some of the countries, it starts from 18 years after the higher schooling age, and then it ends at 60 years of age. So this is the labor force, the number of people, the number of people. Out of total population within the age group between, you can say 16 years till 60 years. Okay, after the schooling leaving age, in a given time period, okay, this is called the working age group or working population or labor force of a country. All the people in a country are not part of the labor force, because we have children and old age people within our country or in population of a country. Above the 60 years of age, we have old age people, and below the 16 years of age, you can say they are the children, they are school living, school going children. So these two are the dependent part of the population. Now, the labor force is divided into different parts. Either these people are actively seeking employment and they are also employed, or they are not seeking any type of employment. Either they are continuing their education or they remain idle or they remain at home. They do not want to work. So labor force is having active part and inactive part. So we say activity rate or participation rate these are those number of people who are actively looking for employment. Either they are employed or they are looking for. They are not counted as they are getting higher education. Like if you people after your A-level education to go for university education, although you are part of this age group, but you are not actively participating in search of job, or you are not going to be employed. So you are going to improve your potential, your productivity for a few number of years. But those who are now out of the university and they are looking for a job, they are called, we say, they are having activity rate. This is the number of people of the labor force who are actually employed at present time. We say that is called activity rate or participation rate. Those who are actively participating in the economic activities to produce the goods and services. That is called activity rate of a country. It depends. It is different for different countries. Why? Some people, they are not actively participating, although they are part of the same labor force, They are not looking for a job because of their family businesses. They remain unemployed. They are voluntarily unemployed. They are not actively participating. Or some of the female population in our country and many of the countries, although they are educated, they have completed their professional education, but they are not actively participating in the economic activities of a country. So we say the activity rate of a country depends upon how many people out of this labor force they have been actually employed and they are working in the country. When female population is going to participate in the economic activities, we say that country is having more activity rate or participation rate, both from male and female population. Majority of time in many of the countries, we are having the statistics which show that activity rate of majority of the countries, that is above 50% of their working population. So when they are having 50% of labor force actively participating and the rest are going to be the dependent or they are unemployed, so we say the activity rate should be higher in order to have more and more economic activities in order to produce more goods and services. If activity rate is lower, then those who are employed, they have to pay more taxes, they have to work hard in order to provide unemployment benefit to those who are unemployed. Those who are not participating in the economic activities, either they are voluntarily unemployed or they are involuntarily unemployed, they need to be paid by the government. Or the other part of the population, like dependent population, like old age people and children, so this active population need to pay more taxes in order to finance it. So activity rate may decrease due to higher income taxes in the upper income group. When income taxes are going to increase, what happens? They are causing disincentive to hard work. And when they are getting disincentive to hard work, what happens? People are getting early retired. So early retirement will also reduce the activity rate or participation rate of the country's labor force. So mainly in this topic, we were talking about the labor force, what is meant by labor force, and what is the activity rate or participation rate of a country's labor force. And then we talked about how activity rate can be influenced by different factors. Okay, now come towards the other things, the productivity of labor. What we mean by productivity of labor? Productivity of labor. How can we define productivity? It is per worker output. What it is? Per worker output, the total output produced by a firm, if we divide it by the total number of workers employed in that firm, we can say this is called productivity or per worker output. It is average physical product of labor, if you remember. What is average physical product of labor? This is total physical product of labor divided by total labor. This is per worker output. Suppose in a firm, 10,000 output is produced by 100 workers. So each worker has produced 100 units of output in a given time period. Maybe in a month, so each worker is producing 100 units of output on average. So we say the productivity, that is the per worker output. So when productivity, it is basically the microeconomic question. So when productivity increases, the per unit cost of production, that will fall. Now in this chapter, it is written how to increase the productivity of the workers when they are working. So that needs education and training. What it is? Education and training. That will improve their their productivity, or the new technology will also improve their productivity. Education and training, experience that will increase their productivity, the invention of new tools that will increase their productivity. So when productivity increases, the per unit cost of production will decrease, the per worker output will increase, and then what will happen? The economic growth, GNI, gross national income, will be increasing for the country, and per capita income will also increase. This is the main thing. The labor force which is present in a country, it depends upon the size of the population. If country's size of population is high, more people will be available for work, and that is called higher population will have high labor force. And when birth rate is increasing more than the death rate, so in future more population will be there, and country will have more labor force, and more labor force will have less per unit cost, because wages will decrease when supply of labor is high. And if they are educated and trained and technologically technology friendly workers are there, and they are having more experience, so in that case we can have more productivity of the workers, which will increase the GNI per capita of that country. That's about our labor force. Now come towards where the labor force is divided into two parts. Now come towards the unemployment, how to measure unemployment, and what are the different types and consequences of unemployed people in a country. In order to study the unemployment, we need to study the labor force. Now the topic will be unemployment. Do you know what we mean by unemployment? These are the number of people of the total labor force of a country. Not out of total population, but out of the total labor force of a country, those who are looking for a job, but they could not find it in a given time period. Okay? The number of people of labor force who are looking for a job but could not find it, in a given time period. So we see over here the number of people of labor force. The students are making mistake in this data, in this definition. They write over here out of population. We are not talking about the population and unemployment, rather we say these are the number of people out of the labor force. Like we are having 220 million size of people living in our country. Out of that, how much are the part of the labor force? Then we will find how many out of them are employed and how many are unemployed. This is the main thing. We say over here, so we say the labor force is divided into employed people plus unemployed. Suppose a country is having 5 million of labor force, you can say 5 million of labor force, out of them 4 million are employed plus 1 million they remain unemployed, then we say out of labor force we can say 80% they are employed and 20% they are left unemployed. Two things are important over here. This is the level of employment, this is level of unemployment, this is not the rate. This is not the rate we say. Okay? So we say level of unemployment means what? When we talk about level, these are the number of people out of labor force who are employed and unemployed. But we do not compare the level of unemployment in a country or with the other countries. Okay? We compare the rate of unemployment. This is called what? Level of employment, level of unemployment. Now, what is the rate of unemployment? How to calculate the rate of unemployment? Because that is taken in terms of percentages. Like this is the number of unemployed divided by the labor force. Keep it in mind, I am saying again and again, don't write over here the population size of the country, because children and old age are not part of the labor force. If in any of the MCQ it is written the total population size instead of labor force, that is a wrong thing. Okay, multiplied by 100. Now see, 1 million out of 5 into 100, that will tell us 20% of unemployed people are in this country. And if you have to find the rate of employment, then we divide the number of people employed by the labor force, that will give us the employment rate or activity rate or participation rate. Those who are actively participating in the economic activities. In our case, it is very high. Okay, the rate of unemployment that needs to be compared with other countries, because every country is having different size of labor force and different number of unemployed people. But we will be comparing the rates of unemployment in each country. Which country is having more rate of unemployment or less rate of unemployment, then their economic performance can be judged. This is the main thing. For example, in our country, according to the statistics, it is 4.5% or 4.9% of our labor force that is looking for job. So that is called the unemployment rate of our country. That means around about 5% or 6% people, they remain unemployed out of the labor force. These are the statistics which are issued by the Federal Bureau of Statistics. Okay, otherwise we will be looking around, many of the people, they are voluntarily unemployed. They are not looking for a job. I don't know whether they have been included or not, although they are part of the labor force. So we see labor force is divided into employed and unemployed. Now out of that, we say the unemployment rate can be found by the number of unemployed divided by the labor force multiplied by 100. So easily we can find the rate of unemployment. Now, what is the way how to say the unemployment is important economic variables at the national level? Because if more and more people are unemployed, what happens, that will increase what the poverty level in a country, that will cause many of the socio-economic problems. Socio-economic problems mean what? If a person is not able to earn enough amount of money in order to survive, he will fall into the category of absolute poverty of a country. So when he becomes a poor person, his family will also be suffering, and at the same time he can or she can be involved in any type of criminal activities. Good. Socio-economic problems will arise, divorce rate can increase, suicide rate can increase. So unemployment, as far as the individual is concerned, that is very, very problematic. It can increase individual stress, anxiety and depression. Okay, so many of the things will be arising due to unemployment, and a person who is unemployed, he is facing these things. How a firm will be facing due to unemployment? When there is more unemployment, people are not having enough income to spend. Aggregate demand will fall and firms will not be able to produce more goods and services. So when more and more people are unemployed, what happens? Firms will be facing fall in aggregate demand in the country. They will not be increasing capital investment for the upcoming years. So when capital investment is not increased and people are not getting employed, less number of goods and services are demanded, economic growth rate of the country will be declining and profitability of the firms will also be decreasing. At the same time, one thing which I left over, unemployment level is a stock variable. Stock variables means what? On one side, labor force is increasing due to more birth rate of the country. So when population size is increasing, on one side labor force is increasing due to net immigration. More people from other parts of the world, they are entering to our country and labor force size is expanding. And due to that, increase in the pool of labor force, if those people are not employed, definitely this will be stocking up, and stock variable means it is increasing day by day due to increase in the size of labor force. On the other hand, when more unemployment is present, we can say the firms can find the workers at less wages because their supply is available. So at less wages or competitive wages, they can hire the workers if they are having their demand of goods out of the country, or they are the export oriented, and in other countries there is increase in aggregate demand, then these firms which are producing the exportable items, they can find the workers at very competitive wage rates. They can be benefited due to unemployment because they need to pay less wages to those workers in the market because already there is massive unemployment. At the same time, how a country will be affected due to this increasing unemployment? You can see, you remember the PPC. This is the capital goods, consumer goods. When there is unemployment, a country is not producing at its full potential. Many of important resources, the human resources, they are being wasted by that country. It is producing below its full potential. Its economic, actual economic activity is far below its potential. So it is not fully utilizing its available resources, those who are educated and skilled one. So economic growth rate will be slowing down. And what happens on the other side? The government's tax revenue will be decreasing. When tax revenues are decreasing, people are not getting employed, government can face budget deficit as well. When government is spending more than the tax revenues collected, the budget deficit will be there. It will increase the borrowing requirements of the government. And now government needs to pay more unemployment benefit to those who are unemployed. So their transfer other payments in the form of unemployment benefits, they will be increasing, and that will cause a pressure on the employed people to pay more taxes as well. They need to pay more taxes in order to finance the transfer payments made by the government, which are made to the unemployed people. Okay, now what happens when income taxes are increasing? So many people, they will be having disincentive to hard work. When income tax rate increases above 50% of their income, they don't want to become richer, they don't want to get their promotions, because most of their income will be taken by the government in the form of higher taxes. They will be using the early retirements, golden shake hands. So you can say, when they are getting retired, again they will be increasing what? The level of unemployment people, because one side they are not paying, they are avoiding the taxes to pay to the government, and on the other hand they are still part of the labor force within the age group of 60 years, and their early retirements will reduce the economic activity as well. So these are what the consequences of unemployment to the individuals, to the firm, to the economy as a whole. So we find them how unemployment is having different types of influences or consequences on the whole society, to the individual himself, to the firms, and to the economy as a whole. So we found it. Now what are the different causes of unemployment? Do you know what are the different causes of unemployment? What are the causes or types of unemployment? Causes or types of unemployment. There can be one type, if we say frictional unemployment. Frictional unemployment, structural unemployment. And then we say cyclical unemployment. What do you mean by frictional unemployment? When we find people are searching a job but they could not find it, this is called search unemployment. Search unemployment, like they have left over one of the job in order to have another one. So temporarily, when they are looking for a job, we say this is called frictional unemployment. Or we say it is casual unemployment. Casual means, you can say some of the teachers, they are doing their visiting jobs. So during the summer vacations, when schools and colleges and universities, they are close down their educational activities, so these visiting teachers, they will become casually unemployed, because at that time educational activities are stopped in the institutions, so they remain unemployed till the new activities will be starting from August or September. So that period of time in which they remain unemployed, we say that is called casual unemployment. First one is the search unemployment, second is casual unemployment, and the third one you can say is the seasonal unemployment. Seasonal unemployment, during winter, in many of the countries or parts of the countries, the temperature that goes down below the level where economic activities cannot be performed, like it goes below zero, negative temperature is there, economic activities are closed down or they are frozen, so at that time seasonal unemployment is arising. So we can say some people, frictional unemployment is that when a person leaves his job and temporarily he remains or she remains unemployed in search of a new job, that is called search unemployment. Casual unemployment means what? When people are leaving one job for the sake that the economic activities have been closed down, many of the actors and actresses, when their movies are completed, till the next movie that is started, they remain unemployed, that is called Kaigo unemployment. And seasonal aside, due to changes in weather conditions when economic activities are closed down, they will remain unemployed, that is seasonal unemployment. You can also say this is the reason why when people, we can say they are having geographical and occupational immobilities, or they will not be able to find a job in their area. So that is the friction which is going to be caused. And occupational immobility, that means the job is available in another occupation, so they are unable to do that. So all these are going to be the causes of frictional unemployment. You can also say residual unemployment, that's also part of frictional. Residual means some of the work, people around us, they are handicapped. They are unable to do any type of work actively, although they are willing to work. Okay, so in that case, that is called residual unemployed. That is also the reason of frictional unemployment. Residual unemployment. Now come towards the structural unemployment. When this is usually we find when the structure of the economy is going to change, like we are using more of automation, we are using more technological advancements in our production processes, then due to new technology can be the reason of structural unemployment. Structural unemployment means when we are adopting new methods of production, where more capital intensive methods of production are adopted by the entrepreneurs. So at that time, they are causing the structural unemployment. You can also find the regional unemployments in certain regions of the country where economic activity or industries, they are closing down. There is a decline in industry because the consumer demands, they have switched over to other products. And their demand has changed, the structure of the economy has changed. Like now people, if they are previously buying domestically produced goods, now they are buying the imported goods. Rather than this one, the demand of our domestic goods will be declining in some of the areas. So due to the structural changes, the primary sector is declining and manufacturing sector is going to have more growth. So the workers in the primary sector in agricultural farming, they will become unemployed, that is called structural unemployment. What is the cyclical unemployment? This is also called aggregate demand deficient unemployment. You remember what is meant by the business cycle or trade cycle of a country? This is what time is here. This is GNI and this is the trend pulse and this is the actual GDP pulse. This is boom and this is recession. So when economic activity is slowed down, aggregate demand is falling, the country moves into recession or depression. And due to these cyclical changes in the economy, moves from boom to recession and then towards boom. When unemployment is changing, we say this is called cyclical unemployment. So during boom, we are having more inflation and less unemployment, but during recession, we have deficiency of aggregate demand. So in the whole country, we can find declining aggregate demand and declining economic activities. So unemployment is caused due to the business cycle changes. So that is called cyclical unemployment. Usually, a question comes, you might have seen that question, what are the different types and causes of unemployment? Previously, I was using the word types of unemployment, but I did not say about the causes. A question came, what are the causes of unemployment? And some of the students, they were saying, sir, you did not teach us about the causes, but actually these are the causes of unemployment. They are also given a name of types of unemployment. So we find over here, question comes, this explain and discuss about different causes of unemployment and what type of unemployment you found in your own economy. Do we have decline in aggregate demand in our country, demand efficiency, or we are having structural unemployment? structure of the economy is changing. Or we have the regional level of unemployment. Some areas they are finding unemployed because industry is declining. Okay, but the whole country is not facing it. Or we have most of the time the frictional unemployment. People are switching from one job to another. Or they are having casual unemployment, seasonal or residual unemployment. So these are the different types. You have to look around what type of unemployment we are having. Keep in mind, some people they are voluntarily unemployed. This is also a type of unemployment. Voluntary unemployment means what? Those who are unemployed by their own will. Nobody has made them unemployed. They don't want to work. That's why they are unemployed. All these guys, they are involuntarily unemployed. They want to work, but they could not find it. So voluntarily unemployed, this is not a problem for a country because by themselves, by their own will, by their own wish, they remain unemployed. Main problem is that when involuntarily people are willing and able to work, but they could not find it. Okay, I think this is enough for today, and tomorrow we'll be doing the measurement of unemployment by two different methods and what are the drawbacks, and then we will be moving towards the circular flow of national income. That's all for today. Thank you.